Now that we know what the hackathon is and how it can benefit us, the next questions we might ask ourselves are, where do we even find this hackathon? When and where is it happening? What are the requirements? Is there a specific theme? How many team members can we be, etc.? All of these questions running through your mind might discourage you from even beginning. So what should you do? Take a deep breath. It's actually much simpler than you think. To begin with, finding the hackathon that you want to participate in isn't necessarily something that you're doing actively. A lot of the times, you'll be hearing about these events through friends and social media. But if you do want to actively look for hackathons and game jams that might interest you, you can use sites such as itch.io for game jams and DevPost for hackathon events. Once you've found an event, all you need to do is read about it to see if it's interesting. Check the details such as the date it's happening, the location, the length of the event, any themes that might be determined, and then once that's done, you can simply press join. Most of these events nowadays have very simple registration through their online pages by simply pressing one button. And now that you're registered, you've successfully taken the first step, which is the most important. Everything from here will be clearer as you progress. At this point, I know some of you are thinking, what if I fail? And to that, I tell you, you simply cannot. You'll always leave a hackathon type event as a winner. Why? Because the experience that you gain and the doors that open up as you meet more people from the industry more than outweigh any regrets that you might have. And those are guaranteed. However, one important thing that you can do to maximize your experience is learning how to stretch your comfort zone. We all know what it's like in the cozy bubble, not taking any risks and not experiencing any inconvenience. What if I told you how much you're missing out on? Because hackathons are a great opportunity to test new ideas, meet new people, and connect with the industry.
Quick break. This video is sponsored by my own company, Immersive Insiders, and we have some really epic news for you. We are launching Europe's biggest in-person XR hackathon, and you are invited. You and 150 other amazing XR creators from all Europe and across the world are invited to Berlin for 4 days of prototyping, meeting amazing people, having good food, being in Berlin, having amazing time basically, and most importantly, potentially getting funded by Meta and our other sponsors to really bring your idea into reality also. Since we only have 150 seats available, of course, I would highly recommend you to act fast, because once you are approved, it is first come first served. So don't sleep on this. Get ahead and apply now. We're looking forward to meeting you in Berlin, xrcc.events, and there we go. I will see you there, and now let's move on with the video.
Testing new ideas. Hackathons are all about innovation. Sticking to your old ideas and methods just won't cut it. You won't be learning any new skills, you won't be benefiting as much as you would if you are more creative, if you try new things, if you use new tools and tech to create something fresh that will highlight your problem-solving skills. But remember, strike a balance. Your projects and ideas should have a good dose of creativity supported by feasibility. Think of this, a creative project is no good if you cannot even start it up, and a functional project is no good if it doesn't stand out. The goal with creativity is to create a project that is different enough and innovative enough that it sparks enthusiasm and inspiration through some kind of viral factor. And to that you add feasibility, which is all about scoping correctly, making a project that is functional, well-polished, and reliable. Meeting new people. Hackathons are also great opportunities to meet new faces and collaborate with teammates from different backgrounds with different skill sets. Plus, you never know if you'll be meeting lifelong friends or future co-workers. When working in teams, it's also important to know what's your focus exactly. Sometimes it's more worth it to work in a team with people that you already know. That way it's less risky, you know the work ethics, you can go further faster, and hopefully create a winning project. But if your focus is more around connecting and learning new skills from the people you meet, then it's worth it to step out of the comfort zone a bit and do the extra effort to make a team with people that you don't know. Even if you do participate with a team of friends, you should still challenge yourself by initiating conversations with people you don't know, individuals from different backgrounds that can offer new perspectives, and you should connect with the industry. Connecting with the industry. Try as much as you can to expand your network. Take these hackathons as a chance to interact with industry professionals, mentors, and potential employers, gaining contacts that you can leverage to further your career goals. And while you're doing that, make sure to be confident. Confidence goes a long way when you're trying to sell yourself or your product. I really can't stress how important confidence is, for example, when you're presenting your ideas to attract the interest of the audience. And the more you train it, the better you'll be able to handle things like stress, team management, and communication. One simple and really useful exercise that you can do to build up your confidence is actually having business cards with you to share with people you talk with. Just the fact of sharing that piece of information with someone comes with its challenges that you might think of. So getting to try that out over and over again and getting the hang of it will train your confidence, and it's also a way to share info about yourself. And that's it for this chapter. I hope you learned a bit about how to stretch your comfort zone and the benefits that come out of it. And in the next chapter, we'll be covering some do's and don'ts when it comes to hard and soft skills relating to hackathon events. So if you're interested in that, stay tuned.